this is the truth. Doctor's appointments, reality shows, worst of all, support groups.
Christ is our friend and he'll be there to the end.
All right. Hazel, how are you doing?
You mean besides the cancer? All right, I guess.
Hazel is forced to go to a cancer support group against her will, and she meets this guy, Gus, there. And both Gus and Hazel have these sort of problems that they're going through. Gus really wants to be remembered, and he wants to leave his mark in the world, and Hazel is really worried about what's going to happen to the people in her life after she dies, because she knows she will, because she's terminally ill.
You need to be a teenager.
If you want me to be a teenager, you don't send me to support group. You gotta give me a fake ID so that I can go to clubs and take pot.
You don't take pot?
So many movies and books talk down to teenagers, or they, you know, it's really bleak, and this movie really does present a hopeful and honest view of being a teenager, and also that the movie's not really about kids with cancer, it's about teenagers, and then they happen to have cancer.
Mainly, it's a love story. I think everyone is really touched by this love story, and it's a beautiful love story because I think due to the sickness, it makes Hazel and Augustus realize that this might be their last and only love, and it really makes them appreciate what's in front of them.
I think we're all trying to figure out the same question, which is how to be grateful for what we have, even though our life is going to give us all the experience of pain and heartbreak.
So, what's your story?
I was diagnosed when I was 13.
No, not your cancer story.
Your real story.
Your hobbies, your passions, your weird fetishes.
The greatest misconception would be something that is true about the film, which is it makes you cry. Oh my God, I don't know if I want to see it. I don't want to cry. But in fact, it's quite irreverent and very joyful.
It's a tragedy, but it leaves you with hope, and it actually is really funny.
I just, you know, want to make sure people aren't too worried about coming to a tearjerker, because it's not only a tearjerker. It makes you laugh. It does make you cry. But almost everyone I talk to, they leave, and they leave with a sense of hope and appreciation for what they have in front of them.
It's a good life, Hazel Grace.
Okay.